Give God glory for all that he is doing. God is an awesome God, and he's continuing to keep us day in and day out, in the nighttime, the noonday, traveling to work. He is always there, always watching over us, always providing for us, and we're thankful for God, who is not just our Father, but he is our King. He is the King of all creation. God is an awesome God. And we glorify him for all that he is doing. We want to acknowledge Pastor Tunstall was on the call. So we give honor to man God. We thank God for Elder Vince, who was on the call as well, for honoring men of God. And we also want to give God glory and thank God for everyone that is on the call. Everyone, you guys are a blessing. And truly, it is an honor to be able to be before you guys, and as we all glean in the Word and learn about Christ. We're going to do a quick recap. But before we do that, from last week, does anyone have any prayer requests or any praise reports that would be encouraging to the brothers and sisters on the call?
I have prayer requests, praying over the people in northern Florida with the hurricane coming their way.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Amen. We definitely will be. Anyone else?
Yes, God bless everyone. I do have a request for a young man by the name of Jacob Raybeck concerning his salvation. And also, once again, for those who are in the hurricane path. And then just souls in general that need today.
Amen. Amen. We definitely will. Is there anyone else?
Just keep my grandson in prayer and my family. You know, we just had two back-to-back deaths, two funerals. It just broke my heart seeing that kid in that casket yesterday. And it's just like, I just had to, you know, it just hurt. So, you know, just pray for the family. And I have a cousin that has stage 4 colon cancer. And she today was a bad day for her. So I'm just praying that, you know, she's okay. And on a lighter note, I feel so much better since I turned back to God. Amen. I'm telling you, I feel like a whole different person. My stress level's down. Even though I have my obstacles that I have going on in the background, I'm carefree about it now. You know, amen. I was able to, and I went, and I'm still haven't went back to smoking. So I'm very proud of myself for that. That amen. Was hard to give up.
Amen.
But I'm not even thinking about him. I don't even care about him. I don't care about anything but God right now. That's
hallelujah.
It.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Everything, I just had to lay it on the altar.
Thank
and
God.
And just, you know, keep my family and my grandson too.
Thank you, sister.
Thank you.
This is encouraging. Sister Krishan said God is keeping her from going back to smoking cigarettes. The Bible says to cleanse yourself from all filthiness of the flesh. And so we will definitely continue to be praying for her there. And everyone else, anyone else have any prayer requests?
I would like to ask for a prayer request for my grandmother who passed today and my family's well-being.
All right. Definitely will. We send out love and condolences to you, brother. Thank you for letting us know, because we will definitely be praying. And not just right now, but when we ask about, does anyone have any prayer requests, we're praying constantly for the brothers and sisters. So just know that it's just not just tonight, but this is a consistent thing. So, but yes, absolutely. You be encouraged, brother. And we are definitely going to pray. If anyone has anything else, now's the time. Otherwise, we will move forward and pray. Sister Angela?
It's just because right now we're in the storm. Well, the storm got to hit us, really. So, safety and protection, and that my boys will make sure that they are mighty men of God.
Amen. So. Amen. Definitely will. Definitely will. Amen. All right, well, let's go forward and let's get started with prayer. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, hallelujah. Lord God, we first and foremost want to glorify your holy name and lift you up, Father, for being the one true living God. Lord God, no man comes to the Father except through Jesus Christ, Father God, Lord. And so we come to your feet now, Lord God. Lord God, you said, come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest, Father God, Lord. And so we know that you are, Father God, a burden bearer, Lord God. You are a yoke breaker, Lord God. You said in your word, Lord, that the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty to the pulling down of strongholds. In Jesus Christ, hallelujah, Lord God. So we pray right now, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Father God, keep, Lord God, every young man, Lord God, is being lifted up in prayer in the name of Jesus. Father God, Lord, we know, Lord God, that the enemy, Lord, is seeking to destroy, Lord God. Lord God, the image of God, Father God, on earth, Father. So we pray, Lord God, that you would sanctify the minds of every young man, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. Sanctify the minds of every young woman in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord God. Father God, keep them, Lord God. Only you, Lord God, can change hearts. Only you, Lord God, can change minds. Only you, Lord God, can pull us out of sin, Lord God. Call them out of darkness into your marvelous light, Lord God. Father God, Lord, and help them, Lord God. Strengthen them. Help them, Lord God, to look up to the hills from which cometh all their help in the name of Jesus, Lord. Father God, Lord, you are a mighty consolator, Father God. So we pray, Lord God, for, Lord God, the endurance, Lord God, of every brother and sister, Lord God, to the families, Lord, with loved ones, Lord, that have passed on, Lord God. Lord God, we pray in the name of Jesus, Lord God, that you will, Lord God, strengthen them, Lord God. Touch their hearts, Lord God. Father God, guard their minds in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Speak your word to them, Lord God, that they will be encouraged, Lord God. Father God, Lord, the joy of the Lord is our strength. Hallelujah. Father God, help us, Lord God, to seek you, Lord God, when we don't understand. Help us, Lord God, to trust you, Lord God, when we don't see the way, Lord God. Father, you said in your word to seek first the kingdom of God and your righteousness, and all these other things shall be added unto us, Lord God. Burdens we cast at your feet, Lord God. Heartache, Lord God, and pain, Lord God, we cast at your feet. Jesus said, let the dead bury the dead, Lord God. Help us to save ourselves from this untoward generation, Lord God. Father God, help us to press, Lord God, to fight, Lord God, for the mark of the high calling which is in Christ Jesus. Lord God, we pray in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Father God, Lord, oh God, that the tornado, Lord God, that the storm, Lord God. Father God, Lord, will not devour, Lord God, the brothers and sisters, Lord. Lord God, that are seeking, Lord God, shelter, Lord God. Father, you, Lord God, provide shelter, Lord God, in the shade of you, Lord, as the Almighty, Lord God. You are a protector, Lord God. You are a keeper, Lord God. Father God, Lord, in the time of the storm, Father God, Lord, we pray, Lord God, for every person's loved ones, Lord God. Lord God, that are in that part of the land, Lord, that may, Lord God, be get caught up, Father, in the rain and the storms, Lord God. Nonetheless, we know, Lord God, that there's one that controls the winds, Lord God, that controls the seas, Lord God, that controls the elements. Father God, Lord, you are sovereign, Lord. The earth is yours and the fullness thereof, and there's nothing too hard for you. Father God, place hedges of protection around them, Lord. Father God, bless their loved ones. Keep them, Lord God. Help them to realize, even in this storm, Lord, that God is not to be trifled with, Lord God, that you are a serious God, Lord, and that with you, Lord God, we have safety. Lord God, we pray, Lord God, for the peace of Jerusalem. Lord God, we pray, Lord God, for every family on this call, every married couple, Lord God. Father God, Lord, we pray, Lord God, that you, Lord God, would lead us, Lord God, into your light, your truth, and your righteousness as only that you can. And we be careful to give your name the praise, the honor, and all the glory. Help us, Lord God, to have long suffering. Bless us, Lord God, with the fruits of the Spirit. Fill, Lord God, the souls with your Holy Ghost in the name of Jesus Christ. Continue to add daily to your church such as should be saved, and help us all, Lord God, to go out and be witnesses in the mighty and precious name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you. Amen. 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 You guys continue to send your prayers in the group chat. This is something that I really want to highlight, especially since the topic is on prayer. We have prayer call every Monday, and tuning into Bible study is great. It's really great, but prayer is where power and connection lies at. And so it's something that Jesus has called for all of us to do. And I know everyone has lives, and if you're busy, then you're busy. But make the effort to connect with the saints of God, because corporate prayer is powerful. The Bible says that one can chase 1,000, but two can put 10,000 to flight. And so there's power in the unity of prayer. We must understand that by ourselves, we are never as strong as we are together, which is why Christ established the church, the body of Christ, so that all needs can be supplied and that we can pull on God and get God's attention. So we're going to move forward. We won't do a poll tonight, but we're going to move forward with the notes. And we're going to finish this off. This has been a three-part series. As we've been learning the purpose and the power of prayer tonight, we're going to key in on the power of prayer and how effective it is. And so please follow along. Take notes if you must need to. And as I always say, I encourage everyone, if you have a question, let's try to reserve them into towards the end of the call. or you could drop them in the chat. But also, there's a raise your hand feature, so we want to make sure that we're not over talking anyone or cutting anyone off, but so that we can receive the word in its entirety. But we're going to get started, and so the scripture that we'll be starting off, the focus scripture will be 1 John chapter 5, verses 14 through 15. 1 John chapter 5, verses 14 through 15. We're talking about the power of prayer. It says, "And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And if we know that he hear us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desired of him." So just a quick recap from the past 2 weeks, as we've been learning and understanding that another word for prayer in the Bible is petition. A petition is a request that you take to someone with authority. In context of the Bible, we take a petition to God because God is the ultimate authority. God is the one who can give the answer to the request. God can grant the request or the petition. God is in all authority. And so it's always important to remember, as we've been learning about, that we must go to God as the ultimate authority. You can't go to God any old type of way and expect to get results. You cannot just speak or talk or present yourself in any old kind of way and expect to get results. Psalm 66, 18, as we've learned, said, "If iniquity be found, if I regard iniquity in my heart, then the Lord will not hear from me." And so we must make sure that as we approach God in prayer, that our hearts are right. And heart not meaning the physical organ, but heart meaning the inner person, the inner man that we have. We must make sure that our hearts is right. Jesus said that these people draw nigh to me with their lips and they honor me with their mouth, but their hearts are far from me. We want to make sure that we are going to God in sincerity and honesty and transparency, but most of all, that we are going to God hungering and thirsting for him more than anything, because that's when God starts to make changes in our lives. When we've decided that we want God in his entirety more than anything, more than any relationship, more than any bad habit, more than any addiction, more than any place that we like to go, more than any opportunity that we think we might have. When that happens, that's when God starts to shift the atmosphere and he starts to move, because now you are in connection with him. Now God is in connection with you. Jesus said, "If any man keep my word, then if any man love me, he'll keep my words. And his Father will come unto him, he'll come unto him, and they will abide in him." And so when you abide in Christ, Christ abides in you. Now you have a connection. Let's get started. So I'm going to raise a question to everyone. Following the notes, it says, what is power? What is power? Not looking for anything specific. Just want to open it up for a little slight discussion. So let me hear from two people. What is power?
Having the ability to make a difference in any situation.
Excellent answer. We get one more person. Don't nobody know about what power is?
A strong force.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Strong force. Good answers. John 1:12 says, "But as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name." He gave power to become the sons or the children of God. What is power? So the Bible uses two different words to explain what power is, and we need both of them, but we're going to focus on one particularly. If you follow along in the notes, it says that exousia, as used in the Bible, refers to authority or power often associated with legal or official authority. Exousia power is power that comes from God. God gives you authority. You do not just have authority. Authority must always be given to you from someone or somewhere else. An example and reference and context with the Bible, we gain our authority from God. We gain authority from the Spirit of Christ. Same thing. And then there's another kind of power, which the Greek word for it is dunamis. As used in the Bible, is a Greek word in the New Testament, and it represents power, strength, or ability, or more so somewhat a natural ability, right? Exousia power, authority. Not everyone has authority to go to God in prayer. And as we've learned about the past couple of weeks, the Bible says that if you do not have the Holy Spirit, then you are not any of God's. You're not none of His, as the scriptures say. And so recognizing first and foremost, because the Bible says that we must pray with the Spirit and with the understanding, that lets us know that we must have the Spirit of God dwelling inside of us so that we may be able to stand before the great authority, which is God, so that we can make a petition. Whenever a petition is made naturally, it must be authorized to even go and stand in court, because the judge does not just grant any kind of petition and does not allow anyone to just come and just grant a petition. But when we have the Spirit of God, we now have the ability to have instant access to be and stand in front of God. The Bible says, let us boldly go unto the throne of grace. So when we have the Spirit of God, now we can boldly go to God, not in pride, not in our own self-righteousness, but boldly because we are fully and we are fully committed and trusting in belief that the one that we are going to is more than able and willing and has the ability to be able to grant the petition that we are going and requesting. That is the authority. We must have the authority, because without authority, you have no power. Many people, as we learned about last week, are seeking power, but they have no authority. And it doesn't work that way. The Bible says after Jesus died, his natural body died, and he went into the grave and was there for 3 days, he came back up. Matthew 28, 18 says, all power is given unto him in both heaven and in earth. So in order to get power, you have to do something. And that means that you must be granted the authority. Let's move on. So how does prayer give us power? Right? So this is another general question. Let's open this up for discussion. I want to hear from you guys. Let's get three different answers. I want to hear from somebody we don't normally hear from. How does prayer give us power?
The connection to the source who has all power, which is God Almighty.
Amen. Amen. Excellent answer. Thank you.
It builds a relationship with God.
Absolutely. Another beautiful answer. Let me hear one more.
It establishes a connection with Christ.
That's right. That's right. That's right. All excellent answers. It connects us to the source. The Lord is our strength. He is the source of our strength, right? It builds connection with God. When we pray, we now have connection. Connection is important because we are called to be in relationship with God. Prayer not only establishes relationship, but it also maintains relationship with God. If there is no relationship with God, then you will not understand your Father. And if you do not understand your Father, you cannot understand the will of your Father. And to understand the Father is to understand the Word. John 1 and 1 says, in the beginning was the Word was with God, and the Word was God. God and His Word are one. So in order to understand the Father, you must understand His Word. And because when you can understand the Word, now prayers can be answered. 1 John 5, 14, 15 says, and this is the confidence that we have in Him, that if we ask anything in what? According to His will. Many people go and they pray, but they're not praying according to the will of God. And I say this often, and I will continue to say it. Many people get frustrated and they walk away from the faith because they think that God is answering their prayer. But the truth is, as we have been learning, that we must operate according to the will of God in order to get the blessing and the power that God has called for us to have. Many people are seeking the Holy Ghost. The Bible says, repent and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. Many people haven't repented yet. Some people have been baptized on this call, but not everybody has repented. And because you haven't repented yet, you haven't received the gift. And it's called a gift because it's something that you truly don't deserve, but it's given to you. Amen? And so we have to be mindful and understand that we must know the word of God. We must understand the will of God. The will and the word of God are one. Prayer gives us power. So we have a few examples. Prayer guides us. Prayer guides us. How does prayer guide us? Prayer guides us because when we go and we speak to God, the Bible says the word, thy word is a light unto my pathway and a lamp unto my feet. And the reason why the word is likened to light is because we live in a very, very sinful and dark world. We live in a... Go ahead, Pastor Tussle.
No, I was going to say the scripture says his ear is inclined to the prayers of the righteous. And being righteous, it puts us in right standing with God. You can not have God's spirit and still set up a petition or a prayer request, but it's not guaranteed, to be answered on your time.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? Scripture said, "This poor man cried, and poor in spirit." You know what I'm saying? Not poor as far as money and monetary gifts,
mm-hmm.
but his heart was sincere.
Amen.
God answered the prayers of the righteous.
Amen. Amen. Plain and simple. Plain and simple. God guides us to his truth. God guides us to his truth. And when he guides us to the truth, now we understand the will. Now we understand, because before we can approach God in prayer, we must understand that we must be right before him. The Bible says, no good thing will he withhold from us if we stand upright before him. No good thing. And the Bible says that every good and perfect gift comes from above, comes from God. And so we must understand that. The power. Psalm 25:4-5 says, show me thy ways, O Lord. Teach me thy paths. Lead me in thy truth and teach me, for thou art the God of my salvation. On thee do I wait all the day. Lead me in thy truth. You know, this is a common thing that we often hear these days, where it's speak your truth and this is my truth and things like that. And the truth is that truth is absolute. There's only one truth, and that truth is that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. No man come to the Father except through him. That every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. So to go before God, to have an audience with God, to be heard from God, you must be in accordance with the scripture. Not only must your heart be right, but you must believe the word in its entirety. Because the Bible says that oftentimes people pray, but when they pray, they don't believe what they're asking for. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. God moves when we operate in faith according to the word. God guides us. It's a form of power. It keeps us from temptation. Matthew 26:41 says, watch and pray that ye enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. Watch and pray. What does that mean? Watch and pray. It means that we should be conscious and we should have our eyes open to the wiles of the enemy as he moves about. We must be on guard. We must have our mind guarded, and we must be consecrated. Many people are very, very distracted in today's time, and because they are distracted, they do not have the ability to see. And seeing is not something that, yes, you have natural sight, but seeing is being able to see spiritually how the enemy is moving and trying to tempt and trying to manipulate. I can be having an argument with a brother, and then God will move on me according to the spirit and say, wait, you don't want to offend your brother. So then at that point, now I have to operate according to the spirit, so that way I am not getting outside of the will of God, and that I now put myself in a place where God won't hear me. It's very, 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 very mindful. The word says, watch and pray that ye enter not in temptation. Many people fall into temptation because